Well, good afternoon, Dunhamers, and welcome to another half-time interview with me, Finlay Jack. I'm delighted to be joined by one of the most informed strikers in not only the league, but probably the country. Someone who's been in back-to-back Team of the Weeks for the first time by any Queen's player this season. It's Conor Shields. Thanks for joining me, Conor.
Thanks for having us.
I guess current form, it's five goals in four games. It's not bad, is it?
Aye, not bad. Obviously, Gaffer's put me through the middle. I think it's worked a treat, to be fair. But as long as I can kind of keep scoring and we're winning, then I'm happy with that.
So one thing I was going to ask you about, actually, you started as a winger and you've moved down the middle for Queens this season. Is that a role you prefer, leading the line?
Aye, obviously, seasons I've played as a winger. Just where Gaffers have kind of put me into play. But before, when I was at Albion Rovers a few years ago, that's where I played kind of through the middle. That's kind of when I got my best joy, I think. And obviously, as I said, the last few years, people have played me as a winger. But with obviously Dobbs being out, the Gaffers kind of look for someone to play through the middle. And kind of, I think I've took my chance fairly well. So hopefully, kind of keeps me there.
Hey, Alan said after the Morton or Dundee game, I think it's time for someone to step up, someone to score the goals in Dobie's absence, and you've done that. How's the other team around you contributing? Because Fitzpatrick's playing well at the minute, Ioannidis playing as a winger, he's doing well, and Dan Pybus has moved into that kind of number 10 role, and he's working his socks off, isn't he?
Like Gaffer said that, obviously, when people look, obviously, think Dobbs, you expect Dobbs to kind of do everything, but obviously, with him being out, we've kind of had to step up and kind of play our part. Obviously, you see Easty, Fitzy and Dan kind of all playing more forward now. It's kind of worked out well, a good bit of energy between us. Obviously with Dan, he constantly runs, so it kind of helps a bit, helps me out there. But as I say, the full team's been brilliant. I think ever since the Wraith game, we just kind of had that kind of belief we had to go and win the game. We weren't really doing too well. Obviously Charlie was in goal at the time, so it was kind of more of protect him as well, go out and put a performance on, and ever since then the confidence has been really high, and obviously just taking it every game. Hopefully you continue it for the rest of the season.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about the Dundee games. A 3-1 loss, I think it was 4 or 5 in a row, we lost bottom of the league, not doing well. What was said in the changing room after that game? Because something obviously changed for the next three games.
I think the week before the Dundee, we conceded 60 Hearts, or 2 weeks before, it was just had to kind of work as a team more. I think we were kind of playing it as individuals rather than a team. Obviously kind of defend from the front, it was a full kind of team effort. Obviously in training, but we're always working hard, to be fair. I think it's just playing the same players in the same positions kind of just started to click a bit, and I think that's kind of starting to show now on the park.
Was there almost an added incentive in that Wraith game, knowing that there's a 16-year-old goalkeeper in goals, to, you know, kind of throw everything in defensively and really protect him?
So like 20 minutes before the game, Charlie was kind of thrown in, so it was just kind of more of protect Charlie. He's young boy, he's only 16. It was kind of, what does the team protect Charlie? Do what we can, and obviously I think to this day is probably still our best game we've played this season. Right from the start, we were right at it. We dominated the game, and obviously I think Charlie had like one or two saves, but obviously as good as he done, I think the full team done brilliant, kind of limit the amount of shots that Rafe had. But as I say, it was just work as a team, and obviously try and get a result on a hard away game.
I want to go back a few years in your career. I think it was 2018 you signed for Sunderland. Big move for you, joining from Albion Rovers. What was that like?
It was mad, because obviously I'd only played part-time, really. I was in the under-20s with Albion Rovers the year before, and then Brian Kerr got the first-team job, so he kind of moved me up, and I just kind of hit the ground running kind of thing. It was like 6 months, just kind of done well. Then got a move to Sunderland. Obviously, it was the first time I played full-time of that. It was like a massive jump. obviously maybe a bit too big looking back, but I was never going to turn down the opportunity. It was a massive move for myself, trying to go and be a better player and stuff, so it was good. Obviously didn't work out, but I'm definitely glad I took the opportunity.
You had a wee spell at Alloa after that, and then Sunderland released you. I think you had offers from pretty much everywhere in the UK after that. You decided to stay in the South. What was the reasoning behind that, staying with Aldershot?
I was just kind of, I wanted to try and stay there, try and get a couple of games first team. Then obviously I didn't play first team with Sunderland, was just under 23s. And then obviously I spoke to the gaffer at Aldershot, kind of lined out where he wanted to play me in that in the season. It kind of sounded good. Just unfortunately, it didn't really work out. I wasn't really fitting any form or stuff. So naturally, you're going to get dropped and stuff. And then I kind of found it hard to get back in the team. And then obviously moving back up here, I've kind of, obviously I was back home and stuff. It was much easier. Aldershot was about 7 hours away, so it was not ideal. Days off to come home and stuff. So being back home has definitely helped, and then obviously settled in really well with the new boys in the team.
I'm assuming that was one of the main reasons for coming back up to Scotland, just nearer to home.
Yeah, obviously I'm back with my parents, so it was just more home comfort kind of thing. I was back home, I would be more comfortable, and then obviously Queen's kind of, they train kind of close to where I stay, so it was another ideal thing. And then obviously I spoke to the gaffer. He was really interested in having me in. And then once I had a conversation, it was kind of done for then, to be honest.
How's it been coming to a team with, I think there's Dobie, Layfield and Pybus, only players from last season. It's an entire new squad. I don't know if you played with any of them before, but how was it like trying to gel together so quickly?
I feel a team of full of new boys, so everyone had to get to know each other relatively quick. Obviously, it was pretty much a full new team. But I think, to be fair, at the start, we kind of, on the park, maybe struggled a bit. But I think now, it's been a couple of months, we've started training together. We know each other's, like the way we play and stuff. I think that's just kind of starting to show now on the park. Obviously, the season only started in October, so it's only really been 2-3 months kind of playing together. I think it's now, it's just kind of starting to gel quite well, so hopefully we can kind of keep up for the rest of the season.
Yeah, you said they're beginning to gel, especially going forward. The goals are flying in from yourself and everyone's contributing around you as well. Do you have any individual aims for goals this season at all?
No, I've been asked a few times recently. No, just, obviously, it was a winger. It was more kind of contributing, like helping set up goals and scoring, but now obviously playing through the middle, it's kind of probably looked to me a bit more to kind of contribute a bit more, but not really any aims, just kind of can get one that continue the form on the now, then I'd be happy. I go a game, but as I say, as just long as I keep scoring and we get points and move up the board, then I'm happy with that.
Obviously, Dobie's out injured just now, we'd probably be back in like 2 or 3 weeks with a hamstring injury. You're going to try and keep him out of the team as best you can.
Yeah, I know. It's going to be kind of hard to kind of put him in, but obviously with some of his quality, it's kind of hard to leave him out. Obviously, that's the gaffer's job. He'll decide kind of what to do with that. But as long as we keep playing the last couple of weeks, then obviously we've done as much as we can, and it's up to the gaffer to put him back in. But as you say, it's if someone has quality, it's kind of hard to kind of leave him out.
What's it been like learning off Dobie? Obviously, he's bags of experience and everywhere in the game. He's unbelievable, isn't he?
Ah, he's a joke. Obviously, yeah. The boys kind of... No, it's before I started training. I was up against him a few seasons ago. It was the year he scored like 40-odd. It was just a joke. But obviously, speaking to him in training and stuff, just kind of take wee bits here and there from him. Like he loves to kind of help younger boys. He happily pass on his knowledge and stuff, so which is good for, obviously, my point of view. I'm sure the other boys will agree. But yeah, it's been brilliant. Obviously, he's played at the highest levels. He knows what he's talking about. So any bit of information he gives you, then definitely take it on board.
And obviously, it's quite a young team this season. You're probably the second most experienced striker at the club. Only 23, I think. How are you finding that?
I know. That's what it's a lot of young boys. To be fair, obviously, yeah, I'd consider myself pretty young, but in that team, I'm probably one of the older ones. But yeah, obviously, compared to the yes, they're only like 20, 21. Obviously, I'm kind of a bit older, so I kind of need to step up as I've kind of done the last few weeks. So hopefully, I can keep doing that. Keep my place in the team for the next, or to the end of the season, and contribute with more goals.
So we've had three good wins. It's three games, Arbroath, Morton and Alloa. No disrespect to those teams, but it's three games that you'll be looking to win.
Yeah, definitely, especially Arbroath and Morton are at home. Obviously, we played against Alloa. We kind of done well the first time in the season, but definitely the next three, I'd expect to be at least 7 out of that next 9 points. I would definitely take, obviously, I don't know with the Inverness game, I don't know when that's rescheduled. But obviously, that'd be a tough game. But definitely, the three you've said, I would expect at least 7, if not full points, from all, considering the former in just now.
And I guess if you're in 8th place, you've always kind of got to be careful looking over your shoulder. But on the form, you'd be looking up the table to try and get into that top four.
Yeah, definitely. As you're saying, like 5 points off our bro for our bottom, so like one game can completely change the look on the table. But if you look the other way, then I think we're only 3 or 4 points off like fifth or something. So granted, the game must be full of confidence. We're expecting kind of push ourselves a bit further up the board away from obviously Alwyn or Broth and try and get a good gap there, and you're not constantly looking over your shoulder, you're more looking up than behind you.
And obviously there was meant to be a Scottish Cup tie between that. It was a home to Hibs. Is that a draw you were happy with? A good chance to kind of prove yourself against Premiership opposition.
Yeah, obviously, Premier League teams, obviously, what you want to be playing against, obviously, play well, then it looks good for yourself. But yeah, obviously, the boys were obviously delighted with that as well. Obviously, I think if you ask, maybe take an easier draw and try and get through the next round a bit. Yeah, but it'll be a good game, obviously, at home. Probably suits us a bit more. Obviously, being on Astro, they won't be too keen on that. But obviously, I don't know when it's rescheduled for. I think it's kind of due to COVID. But
yeah,
whatever that, that'll be good. The boys will be ready for it. Hopefully, we're still in good bit of form and take it into the game.
I guess just one final thing. I think every time you score a goal, there seems to be a barrage of comments underneath Twitter saying, new contract, new contract, new contract. Are you looking to make the move up soon, or are you happy at Queen's?
I'm kind of happy. I'm playing well. I enjoy training and stuff, enjoy playing. All the boys are brand new. So right now, I'm kind of happy where I'm at. As long as I'm doing well and helping the team, then it's good enough for me.
Superb, Connor. Thanks very much for joining me. And all the best on Saturday, mate.
Right, thanks very much.
Cheers.